So today we are discussing AWS IAM. So we will discuss about how to create users, assign policies, as well as create groups. We will actually create our first user, and after that, in later videos, we will come back with more advanced IAM policies. IAM policies, how to define, what are the limitations, how to write a policy, how to create a user group and all, we will come back with later videos. So in this video we are going to just create a user, create a group, define an account alias. We will know that and we will have a demo. So when we create our first account, we create root account. So first account, whenever we create a AWS account, we are creating a root account, and actually it is created by default. So that would have our email ID, and then the Amazon account ID and password. So this is called the root account, okay, and this should not be shared to anyone. The root account is global in IAM scope. So then when we create, why do we need to create an IAM user? Because in root account, if we see, we can do anything. If we give that access to everyone, they can build their own systems, they can use resources which are not required, and our bill will be huge. So let us create individual users and give it. So we are creating our first IAM user. So these users, the IAM users, they can be grouped together if they work for a common task. So these groups, the IAM groups we are talking about, these groups can contain only users, not other groups. So based on the job role, we assign an IAM user a group, and these groups can contain only users. That we need to remember, that we can only add an user, we don't have to add a group in it. We are not allowed. And we can create an user in silo also. He need not to be part of a group, and one user can belong to multiple groups. So these are the facts of users and groups. Now these groups actually are created with permissions. These permissions, yes, we will come along in the next video. We will come out with the permission details, but now let us study what are the permissions. Permissions are written in a JSON document which are called policies. So these permissions can be of allowing or denial on an Amazon service, AWS service. So these are JSON documents which tells about the access of a AWS service, how whether it is allowed or whether it is denied. And the default policy is of total denial, means that first policy which we will create allows access to nothing. So then all other policies will form on top of it, which will give least privilege. That means an user can only have the least privilege for which he is working right now, and that also can be revoked. So let us come to our demo of our first user, group and policy after creating the root user. Thank you. Okay, so here we can see that this is the IAM console, and this is a global service. So IAM is a global service. So we are going to add users. Users are, as we have discussed earlier, doesn't give everybody the root access. We define everybody's every user's limits, and then we give them access. So the individuals who are in the organization, they will have their own individual access. So here we are going to add a user. Let me say he is a administrator who will look after the admin. So access type, there are two access type. We will discuss this in detail. First of all, what we will do is we will give him the console access. We also give him a password, rather say so I gave him a password, and then I just unchecked the required password reset. So this we will see this how if we require a password, if we click it on, what will happen, and if we click it off, like right now I am clicking it off, then the thing that will not happen is they will not be asked to change their password on their first login. So that's a policy. It is said IAM user change password policy. So now we will go ahead and we will create our first group. Okay, so now it is time to create our first group. We will just create a group here for this guy administrator. We will give root user group. So this root user group will have I will select all the AWS. There are 670 AWS defined and managed policies. So I will just attach the administrator access to him, then create group. So he's attached to a group called root user. He has got administrator access. Next, let me say these are the tags. Actually, these are the labels we attach to a user. So here what we will do is we will add say IT admin, and he will be given root access to all users, to I would say manage AWS account. So I can add a tag, then we will just see that user is administrator. He has AWS management console access with a password. Here the password type custom. He doesn't require a password reset. There are no permission boundaries. Groups are root user and tag is IT admin. Here we are on the way to create an admin user. Here we can send this user an email, or we can download his credentials like this. So here we can see that his credentials are downloaded. We can send it to him. Now we will see how to do this AWS console access, how to do the alias setting of this user. So that we will wait. We will see. Let us close this one. So here we can see that user has been created. Okay, so here is the user administrator. If we go to the group, we can see this group has been created with a root user, there is one user in this group who is administrator, and the permissions for this group has been defined. If we go to our dashboard right now, what we will see, we will see that here we have a IAM URL which can be used by the users to log in. So right now if I just copy this one, then I open another tab, like say I would open a tab, okay, let us open an incognito tab. So here it is. I paste the URL. Yes, and now I hit enter. So I can see that this console is open on the AWS. Here we have the account ID. So that is the alias. So alias was, sorry, it was a link to the console. So what we will do is copy the account alias. Yes, here. Copy the account alias from here. Now what we will do is we will log in into the account. Say here, so I put the account alias over here. Then the user is administrator. I give the password. And boom, we are in. I think so. Let us see. Yes, so here is administrator at the account alias. That region we will select later on. So here is,
and
here is the dashboard.